We're now joined by Connie Ledesma, a negotiating panel member of the National Democratic Front. Connie, thank you very much for talking to us this afternoon.
Yes. Good morning to you. Now, is it morning there? It's morning
here. It's the afternoon, but good morning to you, Connie.
Now, so first, good afternoon to everyone.
There was the announcement of the grant of amnesty to members tagged as rebels. And then we have the revival of the peace talks now. And for some of us, it kind of came out of the blue. But would you be able to tell us the backstory? Who initiated the talks for the revival of the peace talks? And what triggered it?
Actually, the initiation came from retired General, Brigadier General Emmanuel Bautista. And he started it about 2 years ago. Mm. He asked to come to Utrecht and to talk to the negotiating panel. At that time, the chief political consultant, Jose Maria Sison, was still alive. So we were able to meet, I think, twice or three times with Professor Sison, together with General Bautista. Mm-hmm. So I think we give credit to the initiative of General Bautista to start the whole process moving again.
So it took 2 years for the talks to be revived again. Now, the joint statement notes that both sides acknowledge, let me read from it, both sides acknowledge the deep-rooted socioeconomic and political grievances, and that both will be working on a framework to resolve it. From the side of the National Democratic Front, what needs to be resolved in order to have lasting peace, and what should be done?
We are still going to talk about it. As the joint communique or the joint statement really just states very general things. Mm-hmm. We have to work on it together, the GRP and the NDFP. We have to sit down. We have to say what are the points that we want to bring up, what are the points that we want to resolve. So no concrete things yet. So I will just leave it at that.
Okay. But it did mention, it noted foreign security threats facing the country. Well, it was a factor in both sides wanting to talk again. We can assume, of course, that we're talking about the maritime row with China. How is the NDF concerned and bothered by that? And how did that become part of what convinced you for the revival of peace talks with the Philippine government?
It is, of course, a major issue. So these are, and as I said, these are still points that we will talk about, and we will concretize it as we go on. So, abangan na lang ho ninyo ang pag-uusap namin.
Okay, Connie.
We will keep you informed.
Thank you very much. And we will be talking to you again about that. We will raise that issue again once concrete points are talked about with the government. Now, in agreeing to reviving the peace talks, the NDF asked for the lifting of the terror tag on it. We have Secretary Anyo saying that the tag will remain until a final peace deal is hammered out. We want to get your reaction to that.
We did not really specify that. It's more in the speeches mm-hmm. of Luis Alandoni and Julie De Lima. So in actual fact, we have not really discussed that on the table with the GRP delegation. So this will be things that we will discuss when we meet again, probably next year, because now the year is ending. So we've made this major breakthrough, mm-hmm. and then we will just wait for probably early next year.
In this agreement to revive the peace talks was, I don't know if you will be able to consult with all of the members, but a lot of the members of the NDF, CPP, NPA, were they consulted about this? I ask you this because we've seen situations before when groups would have an agreement with the government and then a breakaway group would come up and cause trouble to disrupt that agreement. Have you talked to a big part of the membership of the NDF, CPP, NPA, and have they signified their willingness for the revival of the peace talks and for a final peace deal?
In the past, even in the past, if you notice, that there has always been a clamor to revive the peace talks. We have been very careful about doing it until it was General Bautista that came forward with the initiative. Mm-hmm. But in general, the forces of the National Democratic Front of the Philippines are very open to peace talks. Breakaway groups, they are the ones who have differences with the main body of the National Democratic Front, which means that we would not have control about them. If they would have difficulties and they break away, that would be their opinion, and it would not be an official position of the NDF. But right now, the forces of the National Democratic Front are in favor of the resumption of the peace talks. We face this with guarded optimism. We hope that there will be good progress. We will work carefully to ensure that that it will work fine, and we are confident that the members of the GRP delegation that we talked to are also very eager and committed to making the process work.
Okay, we had Secretary Carlito Galvez saying that this is going to be a do-over, and it's not going to be a resumption of the previous peace talks, meaning it's going back to square one. Now, what would the NDF side possibly do different this time, learning from the lessons from the previous peace talks?
Well, first of all, we do not consider it a restart. We consider it a resumption because we've worked for so many years. Actually, the peace talks, or the move to have talks, started in the time of Cory Aquino. Mm-hmm. And then it did very significant gains during the time of President Ramos. So we have a lot of achievements at that time. And we do not want to say that we will just do away with all the achievements and start as if nothing happened. So we want to continue and work on based on our achievements, learning from our shortcomings, and move the process forward. So I do not know what Secretary Galvez means by restart. We probably mean the same thing, but we use different words. But for us, it's more a resumption.
Connie earlier said that it took 2 years, initiated by General Bautista, but did you expect it to happen in this administration?
We were hoping, yes. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Because we were working slowly, and both sides decided to keep it very secret, very quiet, because if you start saying things before you've achieved anything, it's like crying wolf. Until we can show that we have discussed, we have an agreement, and we have a statement to show up the points that we agree on, we decided to keep it very quiet. And so it was a process of, well, first of all, getting to know each other, getting to know General Bautista, him getting to know us, and then deciding how we're going to move forward, and then working on the joint statement. So this is a process of several visits and working together. And I would like to say also that the Royal Norwegian Government third-party facilitator was very helpful and working very closely with us.
Also, you earlier said that you had guarded optimism about this revival of the peace talks. That could be for now, but are you optimistic of peace, finally, lasting peace? And if you are, what would you want that peace to look like?
As I say, guarded. How would we want to...
How do you picture it?
Well, the benefits that there would be a great improvement on the lives of the peasants, the farmers, the workers, the oppressed people, that there would be clear improvement on their lives. That's how I would look at how peace would be. And then we can think then of the cessation of hostilities when that day, when that is assured, when that will happen.
Connie Ledesma, a member of the negotiating panel of the NDFP. Connie, thank you very much. Again, good morning.
Yeah, thank you also.